Alright guys, so like some of you already know, some of our best kept beauty secrets come from the traditional South Indian recipes. These use amazing ingredients, amazing formulas, so I thought why not just do a video today using some inspiration and, you know, creating a recipe which actually works for the modern day lifestyle. So if you want to know more, just keep watching this video guys to find out. So starting with the first ingredient, which is wild turmeric or kasturi manjal, like it's popularly called over here. Now this is a very good ingredient for brightening up the skin. It also helps in dealing with a lot of skin problem, rashes, allergies. So it's a very, very good ingredient to use on your DIYs. Then of course we'll be using coconut oil, because you know how popular coconut oil is over here, and it's actually a really good ingredient for your skin and hair. Then we are going to be using sandalwood powder, because sandalwood powder, again, it's very good, especially for blemishes and hyperpigmentation. It really helps your skin heal itself if it has any skin problems. And we'll also be using Dead Sea Mud powder. So the one that I'm using is from Vyayam Ayurveda. It contains Dead Sea Mud powder with wheatgrass. So wheatgrass is also a good ingredient, that's why I'm using it. But if you don't want to use this, you can just get Dead Sea Mud powder for yourself. Even that works. There's no compulsion that you have to use this brand and this one only. I'm just showing you because this is the one that I have. And last but not the least, we'll be using some milk. Now I am using cold milk over here, and this is raw, which is milk that has never been boiled before. So we'll make our base using equal parts of sandalwood powder and Dead Sea Mud powder. So guys, if you have extremely dry skin, you can use a little less sandalwood powder because it obviously has drying properties. So overall, there is an equal part of sandalwood powder and Dead Sea Mud powder over here. Next to the mixture, we'll be adding the wild turmeric powder. So like I just showed you, now wild turmeric powder, you don't want to use a lot. Even though it's a very effective ingredient, it's a very strong ingredient. So just use a little bit. I have taken about 1/3 teaspoon of the wild turmeric powder over here. Now to make a paste form, obviously we'll be using the milk and the coconut oil. So just taking about 1 spoonful of coconut oil. If you have extremely dry flaky skin, you can use a little bit more coconut oil, but again don't use too much. Okay, so about 1 to 1.5 teaspoons of coconut oil, and for the rest we'll be using our raw cold milk. And of course guys, you need to mix all the ingredients really, really well. And yes, mix it till you have a proper paste form. Now before you apply this mixture for the very first time, do a quick patch test. Okay, so I'm just applying a little bit over here. This is what you need to do. And then observe your skin for the next 15 to 20 minutes. And then just wash it off or just clean it up with a wet piece of cloth or cotton. Then observe your skin for about another 1 to 2 hours and make sure that there are no rashes, there's no redness. Once that is sure, then you can apply it on your face and then apply the face mask. So I couldn't find my brush, I'm using my fingers today. If you don't have a brush or can't find your brush, even you can use your fingers, it's completely fine. Before brushes happened, I would anyways use a finger, right? So just apply it all over your face and neck and leave this on for about 15 to 20 minutes. So I'll just see you in 15 to 20 minutes and tell you what the next steps are. So guys, I'm done washing my face, but because my skin is extremely dry, I'm also going to apply a little bit of serum. So the skin does not look extremely dry right now because, you know, the formula which we used contained milk and coconut oil. But applying a little bit of a serum is definitely a good idea, especially if you have dry skin. If you have oily skin, you can skip this step. So the serum I'm using is the Rosehip Serum, which I've told you guys before, I absolutely love. It's one of my go-to products these days. You can use whatever else suits you. This serum I really like, so I'm using just that one. And anyways, by the way guys, all the product links, details and everything will be in the description box below. And yes, with that I'm done with today's routine and today's quick DIY. If you have any tips, any DIYs of your own to share, please share them in the comment section below. I would love to hear from you guys. I'm actually collecting DIYs to do a separate video, which I'm not sure, it might be a video or a series where I'll be sharing DIYs shared by you guys, my viewers. I'll just try them out and show them to you if it works for me as well. And yeah, so if you have any fun DIYs of your own, please share them in the comment section below. I would love to hear from you guys. And also, I would love to get some likes to this video, guys. So don't forget to hit like to this video, subscribe to this channel, turn on the bell icon for notifications, and keep coming back to Superhaul Style for more. Thank you so much for watching. This is me, Prachi, signing off now. Bye-bye.